Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews, with me, Terry Kay. Looking forward to this one. This is one from the guys at Fulham, well, the Dominion Brewery. Got it cold, because America love their beers a little bit cold. This is a farmhouse ale from GG's, or GG's. Not sure the French connection there, but it's a kind of a Saison style farmhouse. Now, farmhouse originally, what does it say on the back here? To the French, Gigi is a woman who farms. I thought it said farts for a minute. It's a woman who farts. I was going to say, I don't call a woman who farts Gigi. It ain't the name I use. But there you go. To our brewers, Gigi is a Belgium influenced Saison. Alcohol 7.2. Ooh. Quick note. I noticed styles seem to have kind of drifted off the remit at some things. I mean, once upon a time, an IPA was a well-hopped beer, but it was also quite strong alcohol-wise in order for it to travel. Saisons used to be kind of brewed for the workers, farmhouse net, brewed for the harvest workers net, and they was obviously kind of brewed quite low alcohol, so that you wouldn't get the workers going, I don't want to work anymore, I'm having the rest of the day off, all right, bye, or I have a go to the governor or whatever, you know. They would be able to have a few beers, quench their thirst, and then woof back to work, kind of food and thirst quenching at the same time. And beer for many years has been sustenance as well as kind of a thirst quencher. And Saison was brewed with the farmhouse yeast and whatever else, you know. It was that was the kind of the style of the beer, but it used to be a lower alcohol beer anyway. I think around about sort of twos and maybe three at most. But it used to be quite low. 7.3. So, I'm not sure where the Saison comes into the style. We shall see. Hopefully with a slight little, maybe a little bitterness in there. So, for kind of a, almost like, almost a slight lambic background edge. We shall see. I've noticed sometimes you get that. So, if I'm lucky. Let's try that. I've left it fairly cold. As I said, it's an American style beer. No, it's actually a French style beer, but it's American beer. And most of the time they drink beer out of the fridge. And I think they brew for everyone according to that kind of thing. Anyway, I may be wrong. Let me know. But it seems that they brew everything kind of to be downed out the fridge, you know. Anyway, there we go. There's the little proud little proud little deer there, little stag. Let's have a sniff. Smelling quite sexy, quite lovely, a bit malty. Let's pour that carefully, see what sort of yeast we got. Oh, blimey. I've already chucked a little tiny bit. Whoa, that's a lot. Jesus Christ. I don't know if you can see through this. I'm going to pour the rest in this just to show you what I'm getting with the rest of it. We're talking, not wild, we're talking furious. Look at all that. Now, so to me, right, I will drink that and I'll enjoy that. But that is pretty much cheese, peas and carrots. I'll twirl that in, right, and I'll enjoy that. But that, even with a twirl in, it's still, look at that. That's lumpy and bumpy. I've tried to hold back what I could in the first half, but even that's quite hazy. But you know what? I don't care. I really, really don't. To me, hazy says, yum, yum. Seriously. Now, twirling the head, that kind of died down. Vicar's collar, there he is. You can have whatever amount of head. You can have one head and one finger. You can have two fingers. You can have three, four, ten. You can have a fist, whatever you want. All the lot, you know. You know, if I twirl it up a bit more, I can probably get three or four fingers. Two fingers and what, you know. Doesn't really make a difference. On a, say, a Foster's, can of Foster's, you got three, four, five fingers. What it says about the conditioning, you know, it just says carbonation. It says there's proteins in there. It don't often say there's proteins in there. You get a lot of the Muck beers and Muck lagers and things like Bombardiers. They put 405, E405 in there, which is like gluey wallpaper, pasty crap. And it'll be big meringue head, wooey like that. Look at that, you know. That ain't going to die down for 20 years. Look at that. So anyway, let's have a sniff. Still a moaning. It smells very wheaty. I don't know how much wheat they've got in this. But it smells very wheaty. Did it say any ingredients? I would so love to just see an ingredient list on beers. Really would. Instead of taste notes, you know, bit of history, bit of what the brewing's about, what this and that, and then a bit of, you know, a bit about the just an ingredient list. It'd lovely to just, you know, basically do what us guys do. Just tell you a bit about the beer's history and a bit about the style's history maybe and things like that, and then ingredient list, and possibly a little box that says above it taste notes, so you can go, oh, hold on, I just spotted the word taste notes, I'm not going to watch. Because I think taste notes are like watching those tasters of the next film to come. You know, when you're at a video, like a cinema or whatever, and you know, when you see the next film to come is so-and-so, and they show you pretty much all the film. They show the geezer killing the geezer at the end and everything else, and they go, and you know, and Luke, and all that business. I am your father. And then you go, well, fuck, you just ruined the film, you wallies. You know, but there you go. You know, it is, isn't it? It's, by the way, Bruce Willis is the ghost. You know, it's like saying that, you know. Oh, wow, that's at the end of the film. That's what the whole film's about, you know. There you go. Sorry, I've gone off the remit. There is a slight bitterness smell in there, which is nice. And like I say, that slight little, almost like a lambic, almost a wild yeast sort of smell. Little notes of that. You've got little notes of quite a fresh cherry. Strawberry. Oh, something wonderful. Sherbet-y almost. You got the wheat. Oh, something in there as well. Like little pear drops. Like little pear drops. Like smell of, the smell of those. When you open up, you know when you... It may be just a thing my family used to do, but we used to have a tin of jar of sweets. If you was going away on holiday, never had them the rest of the year, but you're going away on holiday, you get in the car, and off you'd go, and you'd have a jar of these posh sweets with like some sort of powdered sugar or something on them, and you take the top off, and there you go, it's one of them each, and oh, that was lovely. And you sit, I think it's to stop us being car sick or something, give us something to think about. But it was lovely, those little jars of posh little hard candy sweets. And you sit in the car with them in the back, and little kids, and mum would hand them over. There you go, there's your one. Grab it. No, not you, that's so-and-so. And all that, you know, that's Terry's, and all that, you know. Lovely stuff. So little hints of those as well, like little pear droppy ones. Right, I'm going in. Or maybe sometime. Cheers. Oh, lovely. Lovely, really lovely. Little nice, very nice bitterness notes. Little lovely fruit notes. There's little marmalade. It's kind of apricot marmalade. There's marmalade, it's apricot jam, I should say. Marmalade, there's little cashew edges, cashew nut edges. There's little toasty notes in there, little lightly toasted bread. Oh, it's just, that's just such a lovely beer. Really lovely. Big wheaty notes. There's wheaty notes. It don't matter what they say. I'm sure there's wheat in there. I don't think, as I say, we ain't got an ingredient list, but yeah, definitely wheat in there. Lovely bitter, dry finish. It's big sweet notes, but there's a nice little dry, not so much bitter, but a dry finish to it, and a kind of pithy finish. That is lovely. I'm going to pour the lumps, bumps, cheese, peas and carrots in, and show my braveness, because I don't care. I do think that the yeast is in there for a certain reason, and it's never played my stomach up, ever. But then I have got a stomach of iron. Twirl it round, give it a twirl, give it a smell. See if we get anything different. Straight away it smells softer, smells more rounded. Now I'm getting apricots, I'm getting banana on the nose. Plantain that you get with, or flambé banana, plantain, those sort of, or barbecued banana, those sort of cooked banana sort of.